Hello and welcome to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind. I am the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari, and playing this on PC. Here are my settings. Really excited to be going into this. So yeah, I changed a few things. The frame rate limit was like way up. VSync was off. I like VSync. And it automatically detected me at high, but yet it says here to it says something here. I don't know. It said to start out high and go lower, which makes sense. I mean, I am recording though, so I didn't want to put stuff on ultra. Not that we have custom. And then the audio I have actually going to decrease this a little bit more. Oh, really? Okay. 80 then. I don't know if that applies the audio, but so otherwise the master volume, 80. Everything else is the same. I did change something. I think this was off for cinematic subtitles. So I turn this on. And my key bindings are interesting because I use a Thrustmaster tactical board, not a keyboard for stuff like this. So I changed a lot of things in there. I will use the keyboards for going into stuff like journal and inventory and stuff like that. You can't even change the key bindings on that, which is interesting. I don't know why. Yeah, cannot be rebound. So tab is ledger. I for inventory, K for character menu. Let's see if I actually remember that. J for journal. Companion menu is comma. M for map, that makes sense. But gameplay, that's pretty much, I don't know. Do you guys like field of view 75? We'll see. Otherwise I'll change it. I think 90 is kind of a standard, but it was already set to this. So I figure I'd keep it, unless you guys have a preference. Tutorials, auto collapse inventory. This is interesting. It only shows you dialogue skill stats when you're close to succeeding, but you can turn it on for always. And I was gonna turn it on for always, but I'm like, eh, I just have it like that. Now this I changed. Dialogue choices don't appear until the speaker has finished talking. I figured I'd have this on so he could, you know, I don't know, decide while they're speaking what we're gonna say, maybe? I don't know if that includes, like, successive paragraphs. Like, you'll see a line and then your response, but then there's like two more lines incoming and it's the same response, then I would turn that off, actually. Quest updates is stuff I left the same. I don't know. Nobody shows this stuff. I figure some people like to see it. So, completely blind, I saw Dr. Phineas say how things are disgraceful, and he's funny, and then it looked like you were about to start to create your character, and I have not seen past that, so no spoilers, please, guys, and, you know, I appreciate it. I love the theme, by the way, and I'm going to put up a separate video just of the music, so normal. So, Supernova is pretty interesting. You can only fast travel to your ship. You can only sleep inside your ship. It's like real life. Okay, let's put normal, though. Story mode, normal. And yes, this stuff, same.
Why stay earthbound when prosperity awaits you in the stars? Come to Halcyon, the only colony on the edge of the frontier, owned and operated by corporations. A trip of 10 short years will feel like mere minutes, thanks to the comfort and safety of your very own hibernation chamber. You'll wake up in a perfect society designed to maximize your productivity with guaranteed full employment. With only a minor term of service, you will become the master of your own destiny when you go out of this world to the Halcyon colony.
Colony ship Hope found drifting. Colonists unable to be revived. Hope to be left at edge of colony. Breach of Hope security corridor. Unidentified ship. Here's the man of the hour. This is drifting here. Curious how he found out about it. If he's part of the corporation, or was part of the corporation. Because they know who he is, obviously. Phineas Vernon Wells. Wanted by Halcyon Holdings. Crimes against the colony.
Hundreds of thousands of colonists left to drift out here forever. Just to keep from damaging the board's bottom line. Disgraceful.
Indeed. Gotta say, it draws a lot of parallels to Mass Effect Andromeda. Hopefully it's a better game than that. I mean, I found Mass Effect Andromeda to be average. It's an average game. Just not as good as Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3. So, I mean, you know. That game, if it was not a Mass Effect game, I would say, hey, they're going to put up some serious competition for Mass Effect if they keep it up. So, just not a good game, just not a good Mass Effect game. But anyway, it's the whole thing. It's the thing with the, you know, going to, you know, uncharted reaches of the galaxy, and then colonists not waking up, and then fighting monsters, and on different worlds, and the action RPG settings is very familiar to Mass Effect Andromeda. Alright, so we have points. We have. Well, we can't put attributes yet. Modify your attributes to choose what you like to specialize in. Beware. Below average attributes come with a penalty. Makes sense. Strength. Affects melee weapon damage and mount you can carry. And naturally, in anything like this, I mean, you could put a point of each and be just good in everything.
I hope you're ready to shoulder a burden, friend.
Really?
Excellent cellular integrity. Not likely to liquefy.
Not liquefying is good. I like to...
Must remember not to sneeze near you.
Below average.
You shouldn't have any trouble digesting our food.
But anyway, I tend to not go for melee kind of characters, but... Well, it helps with inspiration and intimidate. What do I not want that much? Temperament improves your natural health regeneration. Two-handed melee, lie, sneak, medical, engineering, determination. Maybe I'll keep that as average, and I'll keep strength at average. Heavy weapons, block. Inspiration, intimidate. Dexterity affects melee attack speed and ranged weapon reload speed. I like the idea of ranged weapons and staying away from attackers. It's pretty much me in every game. So yeah, one-handed melee, handguns, dodge, block, sneak, lockpick. So I like sneaking, lockpicking. Dodging's always good.
Come on, Phineas, pick one and leave.
All right. Intelligence affects critical hit bonus damage. Long guns, persuade, hack, medical science, and determination. And then perception. Also with dodge. Okay. So do I end up with 2 points in dodge because I put it here and here? Lockpicking as well. And then personality, charm. Charm, effects, faction, reputation, companion ability, cooldowns. Persuade, lie, intimidate, science, hack, science, and inspiration. 0% companion ability refresh. Positive faction reputation reaction. Negative faction. Down 10%? So negative 10%? So I got 2 more points remaining. There are parts I've heard you can get through parts of this without even going into combat, so I'm sure it's not going to work against animals and stuff like that. But what if I make myself really high charm, average temperament and strength, and then I'll put one other up to high as well. I don't know if you get to change this later, or this is just you. This is the way you are, and then you can change your skills from there. See, it's persuasion there.
Next.
I know. This is important. This is very important. Sorry, guys. Perception. I mean, I don't want to be completely bad at combat. That's what it is. I don't know. Definitely leaving strength and I'm leaving temperament. But this affects handguns, dodge, block, sneak, and lockpick. This is persuasion, hack. Hacking is good. Medical, science, and determination. I think I'm gonna go for intelligence. Different kinds of guns, heavy weapons, dodge, lockpick, and engineering. The intelligence. Okay, so I have high charm and intelligence. Hopefully I haven't screwed myself. E is next? Alright. Oh, I can't click on it. Points available too. Well, not a lot. Percent one-handed melee crit chance. Handgun sway. Really? Humans have a 20% chance to cower in fear for 3 seconds after the first time you hit them. The persuade skill is using conversation always has a chance to inflict cower when you first damage a human target. Done up more than that. Okay. Long guns are really good for criticals. Almost half the time you'll get one. Dodge. Distance travel when dodging and reduces the duration of harmful status effects. That's pretty much okay. Block. Bonus armor rating when holding a melee weapon. It can allow a perfect block. Unlocked at 20. Lie. Conversations has a chance to inflict scramble. Slowly attack allies On an auto mechanical when attacking you? On an auto mechanical. What's an auto mechanical? Other enemies instead of you. Okay. There's some kind of robot or android. Robotic thing. Intimidate. Has a chance to inflict terrify on nearby creature when you kill one. Nearby creatures when you kill one. So I'm good in persuade already. And then sneak. 82.2% NPC awareness decay rate. So 82% rate of they become unaware of me. Unlock the ability to sell goods to vending machines. Stealth skill, hack skill. Hack reduces the hacking time and number of bypass shots needed for hacking. It can allow you to hack an auto mechanical. Okay, yeah, there must be some kind of robotic things. Lockpick is a 12. Reduces the unlock time and number of mag picks needed for picking locks. And we've got medical. 12% heal amount granted by the medical inhaler. Increases the heal amount of provided from my items in the inhaler, increases duration effects, opens extra slot. Science. Tinker. Improve your weapons and armor in the workbench. Increases damage of plasma and shock damage weapons. So I have a feeling we're not going to get those until later. Also improves special effect for science weapons. Tinker. Weapon and armor. Okay, inspiration. 3% companion damage bonus. That's not much. Determination! Increases the maximum health of your companions. Plus 122 companion health. So I got 2 points. I'm assuming at first I'm only going to have handguns. I don't know. I might just leave that alone for now and points available. Well,
you certainly know your way around a magpick.
It improves all of them. 9, 20, and 12.
Subtle and discreet. Exactly what I need.
Oh, good. Each point in dialogue significantly increases persuade, lie, intimidate skills. After 50, you can specialize by adding points directly to them. This tells you more information. Yeah. Alright, so you can specialize after this, so you really... Alright. Yes, but in leadership.
Like barking orders? Good. We're used to being bossed around.
So, at least starting out, I'll be able to sneak around and hack and pick my way into stuff. And I'm good at persuasion. And I'm relatively good in long guns. And then leadership, so other people fight for me. Aptitude, okay. No discernible aptitude. Colonist sounded like a nice entry-level career for a person of your skills. Expanding humanity's reach by civilizing? I can't talk. The cosmic frontier was ambitious enough without worrying about your day job. You had the rest of your life decide how to be useful in Halcyon. So aptitude bonus determination plus one. Beverage service technician? The Halcyon colony needs good people, but it will settle for ones who can mix a memorable drink. As a human cocktail shaker, you have made concoctions that could end wars or fuel skip drives. You're still trying to balance out the flavors of a truly signature old-fashioned, though. Drink effect duration plus 3%. That's really nothing. Bureaucrat rank 0. The universe operates on laws, and laws require paperwork. Halcyon is no exception. Something isn't stamped, filed, unfiled, referenced, redacted, certified, indexed, and numbered, then it might as well not exist. Birth certificates included. Block plus 1. If I want to come from being a bureaucrat. Cashier, subgrade, non-supervisory. No transaction is finished without a smile. You live for the ka-chunk of a bit cartridge getting inserted right side up, the redemption of loyalty points, and the promise of a good day. Come back real soon, bye-bye now, are more than empty words. They're a promise and a standard you intend on carrying to the frontier. Persuade plus 1. Construction electrician class wire spooler. Contrary to popular belief, cable management is an art form. Something about hiding electrical wiring behind panels to maximize airflow just makes you sigh with relief. Colonists don't need to worry about the bypasses and workarounds to keep the power flowing. That's your burden to shoulder. Shock damage received, minus 3%. Because you're used to getting shocked, I guess. Elevator operations specialist. A proper lift goes up and down. Anyone who doesn't think otherwise isn't fit to wear the badge. Being especially specialist means something where you come from. A commitment to upward and downward mobility that doesn't have a price tag. Engineering plus 1. Oh, so far the cashier sounds interesting. Factory worker, conveyor operator. Safety and efficiency don't always go hand in hand, which is why so many of your co-workers of the factory were amputees. Amputees? You survived the trenches of the assembly line long enough to know when a hydraulic press just wants to pancake some fingers. Thankfully, you managed to keep all of yours. That's good. Dodge plus 1. It was dodging stuff at the factory place. Farmer, dirt farmer. You got into this business for the tubers, but you stayed for the plowing, planting, pruning, and plucking. If it isn't honest work if you come home clean. Worms need dirt and food needs worms. You're just doing your part for the worms. N-ray damage received, minus 3%. I shudder to see what an N-ray would be like hitting me. Food additive taster. Sometimes quality control means sampling a delicious borscht smoothie, but most of the time it means swallowing toxins until you find one that stays down. You love a good surprise. Now that your stomach lining has the consistency of a broken-in saddle, it's easy to explore your culinary limits. Food effect duration plus 3. I don't know if you guys mind me reading all this. I found them very interesting. Food effect duration? Yeah, janitor, sanitation class. You spend your evenings kneeling over ominous stains with a bottle of caustic solvent in an absorbent rag. How the blood got there is irrelevant, above your pay grade and beneath your interest. You're an artist of erasure. When you're on the job, there's no trace to be found. Corrosion damage received is minus 3%. Tossball team mascot? There isn't a problem in all the cosmos the team spirit and a big stick couldn't solve together. Your last major head injury in the field knocks some extra cheer into you, and you've been a rising star in Tossball's competitive mascot food chain ever since. Doesn't matter that no one knows your face under the mask. You share glory with the team. Inspiration plus 1. Medical technician, junior grade. Prior to leaving Earth, you earned the trust of the medical community's most esteemed junior surgeons, who entrusted you with stuffing cotton balls into pill bottles. Experience on the job made you realize that diagnosing illness doesn't take a formal education when a search terminal and a little imagination will do the trick. Medical plus 1. Safety inspector. In your line of work, the corporation's bottom line needs more protection than its personnel. Guardrails aren't free, thermal shielding needs replacing, and a hatch that seals reliably is a luxury. You're on the vanguard of ensuring that every possible expense is spared, since corners don't cut themselves yet. You prefer to think of workplace accidents as happy little coincidences. Plasma damage received, minus 3%. Science assistant, level 0, class A. You've cleaned out enough test tubes to develop a keen instinct for what goes in them and why. Maybe you didn't get in this business to mop up the leavings of failed experiments, but that's just part of the job. Even if you can't unsee what happens in a lab, you can at least learn from the mistakes and enjoy some colorful nightmares. Science plus one. Sub-sous-chef. The hierarchy of modern kitchen is a ladder of many rungs. Your role as assistant to the second deputy chef's aide is one of middling distinction, but you are honored to pour your heart into the ritual emptying of grease pans and the back-breaking labor of gravy restoration. You're holding out for that advancement to poultry inspection, which is due any year now. One-handed melee plus one. So I think... well, this improves persuasion. Plus, I like the fact that I used to be a cashier, and now I'm like a colonist on some planet. Alright, cashier, subgrade, non-supervisory.
Handle bits for a living, huh?
Could say that. Alright, so... female. He has got a weird... well, it looks fine from there, but his nose looks weird. Alright. Head 1 out of 15. It looks strange the way they shift, don't it? Kinda cute. It's number one? Oh. No, it's number seven. Torn between this one and this one. Alright, skin tone. Eye color. 1 out of 26. How many different eye colors are there? There can be freaky ones, I'm sure. That green, though. That's a really pretty green. Plus, you knew it'd be like purple. Oh my god. I don't want it to be too weird. Kind of really impressed by this. I mean, the only Obsidian games I've played, you know, don't be shy, it says, are Pillars of Eternity and South Park Stick of Truth, so this is really a lot more realistic than those. Brow forward, vertical. Yeah, I'm playing on high. I have a, for those I'm wondering, I have a, well, the more details are on the about page of my channel, but I'm using a GeForce GTX 970. So the recommended specs for the graphics card are higher than that. So luckily I'm quite above the minimum specs. This is why I'm not attempting Ultra. I don't think I could pull that off. Especially if we're recording. Shadow play only takes a little bit away from the frames per second. Not much of all, but still, I don't think I would get it. Oh no. Can I change this stuff later too? Is this like including these like cheeks or cheekbones? I guess it's your cheekbones. Nose vertical. Nose tilt? Oh, really? Okay. Thing I learned from Mass Effect is make sure the nose doesn't look horrible when you're looking at your character from the side. Nose size. Oh my god, what a honker. That's the only reason to mess with. Some of this stuff I see no reason to mess with. Yeah, it's gonna be the entire video just doing this. Not surprising. I didn't realize it would be so much customization. I think my character's looking younger and younger as I go. I'll leave that brow vertical. Gives you more of like a expression than like I think she looks younger than when I started. So we haven't gotten even into hair yet. Okay. So then hairstyles. I like that. Pretty cool. They are short hairstyles. But we're not even halfway done after all. Well, like, I guess you gotta have it, your hair put back in some manner to allow for 14, I like. So you can be in combat and stuff. Or not, or you can just have your hair down. Hair is a woman's crowning beauty. Michael Landon. Little House on the Prairie. It's a real quote. Or it could be a crowning something else. Why is she balding? Better bald than balding. Is that too much to have that much hair and up? Well, you can see the color the most when you do that. Green hair and green eyes. Do they have a... No, you can't make her tilt up. Okay. This looks really young now, my god. So the reds are near the end, and there aren't... Really, that. There's no like crazy red. Alright, I don't know if I'm staying with this hair. But a lot of the others I just don't like. I know, guys, I'm so indecisive. Fine, whatever, we'll go with this. Eyebrow style. You know, I'm just gonna change to this so we can see the eyebrows quicker. I mean, easier. That is better than... It's a little bushy. That's... oh my god. Unibrow, no thanks. Wait, the hair color. Oh, I changed it. Hold up. That's like a dark red. Where was I with hair color? Like that. What is with the unibrow I keep seeing now and then? And then no eyebrows. You ever see someone without eyebrows? It's like you don't realize... You're looking at them and you, like, something looks off and you can't figure out what it is because... I mean, I can't. Because how often do you specifically look at someone's eyebrows? Wait, this rounded one? I might end up staying with this hair, I don't know. Facial hair. Oh god. Oh Jesus. Seriously, I could see someone really doing this with the male character anyway. I could imagine some Let's Plays up with that kind of... Yeah. But anyway, yeah, no, none. Facial hair color, well that's... NA, not applicable. This doesn't even look red. This? It's got some red in it. 46. That's that dark red I saw before. Okay, 46. I don't know. Should I just stay with this? Kenny Wizards on Twitch, so you can guys could tell me. Yeah, that one's good. He's a cutie. Okay. Features. Makeup. Oh, this is where we get crazy. No. Oh god, no. Really? No separate lip color? Oh my. Yeah, most of these are just like, hell no. Is that really makeup? Or just the complexion. It's not freckles. My god, she's dead. Oh my god, she got a nosebleed? Imagine walking around with a permanent nosebleed. Oh my god, she got beat up. I don't know. I don't know about that. I think it looks like too much with that complexion. I'm not gonna have dirt, but just... Jeez. It looks like out of a horror movie. Scars. How sad. Age. What changed? Oh god. Look at that. Okay, so that's like a slight wrinkle. Yeah, by the nose, you can see. Alright. I'm gonna leave that as is. I don't know. So... I think I only like this one, but not with this complexion. Skin tone, rather. Well, skin tone looks better now that there's some makeup on it. I like this better, though. Yeah, this one's the end of Freaky. Alright. I'm gonna stop messing around here. Blue eyes like that. Oh, I changed that. I meant to change this. I don't know. Does she look better without the makeup? Not with that, no. Now that I changed the complexion, no. The skin tone, rather. I don't know, am I... Oh look, they have a randomize. Am I satisfied? Looks like she does have dirt, but she doesn't. I guess red hair looks better with a fairer complexion. And I like the green, but not that green. Actually, yeah. I'm looking at the insignia on her back. She's a cutie, though. Can I find a green that's not so insane? Does that? No, that was the green. Okay, never mind. That was the only green that's not insane. Alright. Hopefully you guys like this... Oh god, name? I have no idea. I have no idea about name. How the hell am I supposed to know what kind of name? Ugh. Whole name? Um... Okay. Like a changed around version of Arthur C. Clarke. Okay. Except. Okay, summary. Alright, it's just showing us. Oh, really? One of these I didn't say. Unlocked ability. Doors and containers requiring one mag pick to unlock are free to open. Free to open meaning you can open them, or free to open meaning you don't need a mag pick. You can order companions to do special attacks. The inhaler heals you and your companions, but they get 30% of the healing effect. Oh yeah, I need all that stuff. Ooh.
Looks to be your lucky day, my friend.
Only has room for one?
Not likely, bootlickers. Initiate skip jump.
Sweet.